Hello, and welcome back to another round of PTCGO. We're looking at a new deck today, a deck that just this weekend sees a lot of traction, especially over in Europe, in the Malmö regional, the Limitless crew using this deck, which is it's a Zoroark GX variant, and it's Zoroark combined with a new Vivile from Ultra Prism. What does this Vivile do? It's a stage 1 Pokemon, and its main attack is Evil Admonition. It does 50 times the damage for each of your opponent's Pokemon that has an ability, so it's a really good counter in the mirror match against other Zoroark GX decks, as well as most decks nowadays have a lot of Pokemon with abilities. So it should be fairly effective as a single prize attacker. I saw also in the other US regional, which is currently going on, that a number of people played this deck. I don't know what deck lists they're using. We'll find that out hopefully tomorrow. So I came up with kind of my own variation of the deck list. I looked Yellow Swallow, I think a couple of days ago, built kind of a little bit different variation of this. What I'm doing is, in order to have consistency, I'm using 4 Zoroark and 4 Zoroark GX. In the words of Todd Radcliffe, you never can have enough Zoroark GX in your deck, so this is a full line. And then we have 4 Sneasel with 3 Weavile, so 4-3 lines. A Mew EX for the counter to Bustle decks. And then 3 Tapu Lele again for consistency. Other cards, relatively standard. So since we're playing Ultra Prism, we have here a combination of 2 Cynthias, 4 Ents, and 2 Professor Sycamores. We have 3 Gasmas, a Field Blower, 4 Puzzle of Time, Rescue Stretcher, Super Rod, Ultra Ball. And in this deck, I'm trying to play Devoured Field, since a lot of times that additional 10 points can make the difference between a knockout or not, especially with Vivile. So let's see how that works out. 3 Bridgets, again, consistency on the first turn. 2 Choice Band. And then we have 4 Double Colorless Energy and 4 Dark Energy. So let's get started and try out this deck. I'm hopping here in the versus ladder, and okay, Zoroark Vivile. Here we go. Play. Let's see who we are facing first. I assume it's another Ultra Prism deck at this point in time. So Metal Psychic, Water, a lot of stuff there. Could be a Duck Trio deck. I don't know. Let's see. Yes, we want to go first. Even so, that Sneasel has kind of an interesting ability to attack or discard an energy, and only if you're the second, it's still good to go first. Okay, my opponent takes a Mulligan, and we have to start with a Lele, which is not ideal, but it's actually can be pretty efficient. We have a DCE here, and with that, we can attack in the second round. Okay, so we see here Magnezone, we see Metal Energy, so probably Magnezone, Duskwing, Necrozma, Magnezone would be my guess. Okay, we want to draw an additional card, why not? Even more Leles. Now we have all 3 Leles. Alright. Okay, and 2 DCs. So let's go with the Lele for the Bridget. Okay. Here's our Bridget. And then we have a Vivile here. We have the Evosoda, which will allow us to get Zoroark in place. So let's play the Bridget. And in this case, we have 2 Zoroark. And then maybe 1 Sneasel. Yeah, I think that's good to get a start. Let's see what else we have. We have 3 Zoroarks. Hi, Max.
Why aren't you using your face cam?
We have Vivile. I'm using this cam.
Oh, never mind. Yay!
And then, let's see, energy-wise. So we have only 2 DC, so 2 DC are priced. So this will be, oh no, we have them in hand. Ah, silly me. So,
checked out my Subnautica series.
All right. And then I think we're done with that. All right. Jeez. And let's attach a DCE to the Lele here. And with that, we are handing over to our opponent. Okay, so let's see. So he benched, he put out the Vulpix for the beacon attack, and here's a Magnemite, a metal version. 3 metal energy cards, we can put them in your hand. I haven't even seen this one. It's pretty cool. All right, and a Oranguru and a Skylar. Starting right away with a Skylar doesn't seem like the best idea, so he wants to rare candy, which he can't do on this turn. Okay, he might need to actually N him. Yeah, we definitely want to N him. All right, let's see what we get. We get another Bridget, which we don't need. We have the Evo Soda in hand, so that's awesome. So let's get the Zoroark in place. What do we want to attack with? Yeah, we probably want to attack with the Zoroark. How many abilities? Not so many yet, but here's the Oranguru, that's good. So that's for later. We want to evolve the Weavile. And then we want to probably get rid of his hand. But we don't need any Bridget, so maybe at this point in time I'm going to do a trade. See what we get for that one. Dark Energy, and we have the N here, so I'm not using the Lele yet. I'm just using the N. We have enough, way enough Pokemon to knock this Vulpix out, so I'm not bothering to put more Pokemon on the bench, but I'm gonna use the Devoured Field to get rid of his Mount Coronet. And our opponent, Sofita, gives up here. Well, that was a short one. Let's jump into another game, since this one wasn't really all that exciting. Alright. Well, gives us some ladder points. Okay. And here we're gonna get what? 225 coins. That's always nice. Now we're going up for the next one. Okay, let's do another game here. Grabbing something to drink. The key of the deck will be to get a lot of Zoroark out in the early game and then have Weavile as a late attacker. Okay. So our opponent is calling the coin flip, but we won. So we're gonna go first again. Let's see what we get. Wow! 3 Zoroarks! That's amazing. That's totally awesome. We don't even need the Bridget at this point in time. Okay, so we're gonna just put all these guys down and then we're done. So in this deck we have Dark Energy and DCE, so we can also use a Dark Energy to attack with Zoroark. Let's put the choice band if we want to. Let's try this out in this case. Trying to think how we do this at best. He plays a Cosmog, so that means he probably has tons of evolutions to do before he can attack. I don't really see a first turn attack, so I'm going the risky way, put 1 Dark Energy on this guy, and then I'm gonna use the Sycamore. get some more cards. So we have a Mew, which we probably don't need. We have a Rescue Stretcher, that's good. Super Rod, okay. Is there anything else we want to do at this point in time? No, probably not. For next turn we have the Zorak. We will need one more energy. Okay, I think we are done. Okay, so here's Cosmog. So we are looking at a metal deck. So Solgaleo, probably with Magnezone, something like that. Okay, here comes the N. Okay, here's another Zora, and a Zorak, and an Ultra Ball, and a Lele. Okay, looks pretty good. We just need to get one more energy in play. Do we have anything discarded? No. Good. Okay, so our opponent brings out a what? A Lele for Pritchett. Okay, here's a Lele. And here's a Pritchett. Okay. Yeah, but he played the N already, so he can. So we're gonna get that Sneasel out. Gonna get another Zora out. We're gonna get this Zorak out, and we hope we're gonna get one more Dark Energy. Hopefully, we have a. Let's do a trade here for one of those Tapu Leles. So we have now two Ultra Balls and a Gasma. So what do we want? He didn't seem to have a very good card, so I don't want to give him an. We could Sycamore, but probably we want to. Okay, let's bring out one more Zorak. And then we gonna Lele for. I think the Thinsia is the best option here, so let's use that one. That ensures that we don't lose a Puzzle of Time, which we will need later to get cards back from our discard pile. So I'm gonna play the Thinsia and hope to get an energy. Okay, we get a DCE. Let's put the Devoured Field here. And let's do one more trade. I don't think we need the Sneasel at this point in time. Our bench is pretty full, so let's see what else we get. A Super Rod would allow us to get back just one Sneasel, no energy yet. And we have Mellows to come for the next turn. So I would say at this point in time, even though it's not the most efficient thing, let's do a Riotous Beating for the knockout here. Alright. Okay, we have a Pritchett, which is great. Pritchett is always good trade fodder. He has a Pritchett as well, which we knew about. That's fine. I guess I could have end him, but. Okay, so Gardevoir is in play here. Interesting. Gee, what gate? I have no idea what this is supposed to be, but we have two Puzzle of Times. Is there anything we want to have back? Like, we can get that Weavile back. We can get a Cynthia and a Gasma back. Okay, so good cards to get back here. Is there a Choice Band? Nope. So what do we really need at this point in time? He doesn't really. He has only one Pokemon with abilities, so. That doesn't help us. We have N, we have Super Rod. Let's Mellow for another DCE and another Zorak. The more Zorak on the bench, the better. And if we can get one loaded with a DCE or Choice Band, doesn't really help us, right? Yeah. We would need to have the Kukui to win here. which we don't play in this deck. So we're gonna just go for the DC. Okay. And then we're gonna trade the Bridget. I'm gonna evolve, let's say this Zora. Put a DCE on this one. And we're gonna double Puzzle of Time. And we're gonna get our Weavile. And what else? Maybe a Cynthia. Gasma. I'm gonna get Gasma back. Alright. Don't really need that many draw supporters at this point in time, given we have. Can I do another trade? I should be able to do another trade, right? Yep. Okay. Let's trade at this point in time. We need an N. I'm trading the super rod. Okay. The rescue stretcher. Anything we want to bring back? No, not really. And we can do another trade. Maybe for the rescue stretcher, okay? And then we're gonna evolve here. And then we're gonna do rider speeding. I feel playing four dark energy is way thin. I seem to have a hard time to get anything on the Weavile, but let's see. For now, should be fine. If you evolve those in Gardevoirs, those have special energy or special abilities. This will have special ability. This will be Sylveon. Okay, let's see how this goes. Okay, he attaches to the rods. So he might have already given up on the Tapu Lele, or he has a. Yeah, he doesn't have a Floatstone in hand. Okay, here is our fourth Zoroark. So we have the complete Zoroark line up and running, which is pretty amazing. So at this point in time, I actually don't want to take out the Tapu Lele. I think it would be much more efficient for us to go for, let's say, this Rawls. And ensure he doesn't evolve into Gardevoirs. Let's just go with this one. Bring out this one. Do we want to do a trade? Don't really need the Mew in this matchup, so let's trade the Mew. Don't want to trade too much anymore, because deck out is definitely a possibility here. But eventually I want to get my another energy. So let's just go for a ride speeding to get this guy out. Alright. Here's a Puzzle of Time. Okay. He's bringing back the Tapu Lele. I don't know if that's a good idea. Because I'm in an even price game now. I have four, so if I knock out the Lele, so he Gasmas, okay? Okay. So we want to have a Floatstone, DCE, Gasma, something like that. Doesn't look like we have anything interesting right now. We can Mellow, obviously. Okay, why don't we... but then we can't... let's see Gasma. We have three Gasma in the deck. We played one. I think at this point in time... What do I want? Do I just want another DCE? I mean, both could work. Let's do one trade and see what happens. I don't think we need the Ultra Ball or the Sneasel at this point in time. I want to feature the Weavile, but in this matchup doesn't really make a lot of sense. Evo Soda. No, let's play it safe. Play the Mallow here. Pick another DCE and let's see. So we have a bunch of Gazmas. Why don't we pick a Gazma for the next turn? Either that or. Yeah, that should be fine. And then we're gonna do a trade. And we're gonna get rid of. I don't think we're gonna play a lot of ants anymore. Attach this guy. And then Riot is speeding for the knockout. Okay. Alright. I'm sorry, these are probably not that exciting matchups. My opponent has a kind of clunky deck going with a lot of different complicated evolutions I see here. I mean, so he wasn't able to really get this started. Okay, he's gonna attack with the Layla. Looks like it. Okay. Energy drive for 80. And at this point in time, we just gonna knock him out. Okay. And then we just need to take one more card. He could still, I mean, get a rare candy, get a Gardevoir, which he got, so let's see. Also got late. Okay. So that will keep it a little bit interesting. Galate has 150. Okay. But he will need a DCE to attack first. We just have one card left and we have a Gazma. Yeah. Let's see. He will probably evolve his type null as well. Which makes sense to Silvally. Okay. Field Blower. What do we even have? A Choice Band? Okay. Also Devout Field. 10. Yeah. Okay, Premonition. So he can look at the top 5 cards and sort them in any way he likes. Fine. So he wants to obviously get an energy. So what do we do? $170. Okay, so he has a DCE. So here comes a sensitive plate for the knockout. Gonna bring out this Zorak. Alright. So, 1, 2. He has 3 Pokemons with abilities, so that's actually enough for us to win this game with Evil Adomission. Okay. So, we're gonna go for the. I need Choice Band 2, 150 plus Choice Band, right, that should be enough. Okay. And we're gonna bring out this Weavile. And then we need to have a Choice Band. There should be Choice Band in our deck. Bring this out too. So let's do a trade. One more trade. Okay. And maybe another trade. Right now I would make 160, so 10 short of what we need. It's super annoying. This Bridget we definitely don't need. Okay. I was pretty sure there is another choice band. Will it be the last card? Okay, that's fine. Do we want to do, we might want to do an energy attachment. We already did that, because of time. Okay, so we're gonna go for the evil admonition for 160. Huh, that was sad. So he has a basic Pokemon have no retreat cost. I was like, how did he just retreat for free? All right. He's gonna knock out the Weavile, fine. Yeah. This took much longer than I expected. Okay. So we're gonna bring out a Zorak. Oh. And then luckily we didn't deck out, so now we Gasma for this guy, and then we're gonna go for the Rider speeding for the win. Alright, good game. Okay, I think that's it for today. I think there's definitely some fine-tuning to do on the deck. But these were, I would say, two fairly easy matchups which we won here. I probably would look at the energy distribution a little bit more, but that seemed to be fine. The Pokemons, yeah, it really depends. We would need to see some kind of tougher matchups to really determine what's missing here, but seems to be a pretty solid deck. So thanks so much guys, and see you later.